Praise the Lord. Turn your Bibles to the book of Micah. Micah chapter 7.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord
Jesus. Matthew chapter 10.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Glory to the name of God.
Micah chapter 7.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Matthew chapter 10.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah,
hallelujah. Glory in your name, Jesus. Glory in your name, Jesus. Glory in your name, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Micah is Old Testament, or
Law
of Prophets.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Chapter 7. And Matthew chapter 10. Precious God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for your love and kindness, for your mercy and your grace. We thank you for worship. We pray that the word of God would go forth and that it would be edifying to all those who have an ear to hear what the Spirit has to say to the church. Very familiar portion of scripture. I once heard a black Israelite, I believe it was, teaching on Matthew about the enemy. How Christ said that you got to hate everyone before him, meaning put him before everyone else. And the gentleman was saying, what kind of God is that that says you have to hate your mother, your brother, sister, which doesn't mean necessarily hate, but to put God first. But what he didn't understand was they believe in the Old Testament only. What he didn't understand was that Christ was quoting from Yah. He was quoting from the prophets. And I just want to talk briefly. I was speaking with someone, and the scriptures came to me about a man's enemy. The enemy is closer than you think. Micah says, woe is me, for I am as when they have gathered the summer fruits, as the great cleanings of the vintage. There is no cluster to eat. My soul desired the first ripe fruit. The good man is perished out of the earth, and there is none upright among men. They all lie in wait for blood. They hunt every man his brother with a net, trying to set a snare. They that may do evil with both hands earnestly, that they may do evil with both hands earnestly. The prince asketh and the judge asketh for a reward. The great man, he uttereth his mischievous desires, so they wrap it up. Talking about briberies and illegal dealings. The best of them is as a briar. The most upright is sharper than a thorn hedge. The day of thy watchman and thy visitation cometh now. Now shall be their perplexity. Micah was prophesying. And he was telling the conditions of the world. And it's amazing how that, even as it was in the days of Noah, even so shall it be in the times of the coming of the Son of Man, that the mind of man is evil continuously. This is why we must always strive to be one with Christ. Because the evil will continue to abound, but the scripture does say grace will more abound. But because the devil is the god of this world, you don't fight to have a good mind. You fight to keep evil out of your mind, if you understand what I'm saying. Even a child doesn't grow up doing good. You have to teach that child not to hit. not to hurt. Because it's human nature to go the other way. And the thing about it is you say, and I hope everybody can hear me, you say that, oh, it's nothing big, it's just a small thing. But all of the corruption in the world today, all of the violence in the world today, the destruction of family in the world today, molestation, the rapes, the murders, the drug addictions, the wars. Domestic violence is at a high, and most of it goes unreported. FBI states that every 15 seconds, a woman is being abused. And out of the 50% of people that abuse their family, abuse their children too.
Man.
And you say that this is something small. We teach certain things, amen, to help us to walk upright and to keep us disciplined. And you might say, well, this doesn't matter, that doesn't matter. But all of the corruption in the world today, is anybody listening?
Amen.
Started from a single conversation. All of this came from a conversation. All of your trials, all of your tribulations, all of your pains, all of your burdens came from a conversation when Eve decided to talk with the serpent. Whoever would have thought out of a conversation, thousands would go to hell. Millions would be murdered. Families would be destroyed from a conversation. So don't ever take anything for granted. It is always important that as much as you can, strive to keep your mind on Christ. Strive to keep your mind on Jesus so that you can be counted worthy. Because you're going to be bruised. You're going to be wounded. You're going to be disappointed. And many times your eyebrows will rise when you find out who your enemy is.
Amen.
I feel a virtue. Micah was saying, where is the good man? It seems like everybody's doing wrong, and those who appear to be good, they're like thorns. They're sticky. You can't trust them. The court system, the judges, and the rulers are all taking bribes. They're working together. The great men, you can't trust them. So then the prophet says, trust you not in a friend.
Man.
Put you not your confidence in a guide. Keep the doors of thy mouth from her that lieth in thy bosom. Even be careful what you tell your wife.
Amen.
Then he says, for the son dishonoreth the father. The daughter rises up against her mother. The daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. And a man's enemy are the men of his own house. Now you see why sometimes you fight the spirit of rising up against your own. Now you understand why even your own blood sometimes rises up against you. It's prophetic. However, in Christ, it can make a difference when a family centers around Christ. Peace can remain. But it's when you step outside of the grace of God, when you step outside of the mercy of God, this scripture kicks in. Then he said, therefore, I will look to the Lord. I will wait for God of my salvation. My God will hear me. Even though the enemy may be those of my own household, those close to me, those around me, there's still hope, because then what do? Then you still have an obligation to look to God. You still have an obligation to trust in God. You still have an obligation to do what's right. Now that was Micah. Now you turn to Matthew's chapter 10. You see, think not that he come to send peace, but he doesn't. Jesus came to send a sword. He came to see who's going to serve him and who's not. And the scripture makes it plain that you have to make a decision. If you're going to put God first, or your family first, or your friends first. Jesus said, who is my brother, my mother, my father, and my sisters? Them that do the will of God. Amen. Everybody that is blood, everybody that is family and blood, amen, don't always treat you like family. Mm-hmm. And Jesus gave the parable when it was asked, when he said, love thy neighbor as yourself, and the Jews said, who is thy neighbor? And Jesus gave a parable. There was a man on the road, and he was beaten up. And a priest came by, a holy man, looked at the guy, and kept walking. Then a Levite came by, one of the children of the priest, or a Pharisee, or whoever, looked at the man, and kept walking. But then he said a Samaritan came by, whom the Jews considered as dogs. They didn't consider them as good people. He said a Samaritan came by, took the man, patched him up, strengthened him, picked him up, took him to an inn or hotel, paid the hotel owner money, and said, take care of him, and whatever he needs, give it to him, and when I come back, I'll pay the difference. And then Jesus replied, now who was his neighbor? Them that treat you like neighbors. Who are your brothers and your sisters? Them that treat you. And according to the scriptures, them that serve the Lord. The time has come where you have to decide who it is you're going to serve. In Matthew chapter 10, Jesus says in verse 16, he said, behold, I send you as sheep in the midst of wolves. Be ye therefore wise as serpents and harmless as a dove. Yea, man, we're not supposed to take vengeance into our own hands. He said, but beware of men, for they will deliver you up to the council, and they will scourge you in their synagogues. The synagogues were their churches. Now you see why sometimes we get wounded in the house of the brethren? Yeah, you got folk in church that will dog you out. Amen. You got folk in church that will talk all about you, scorn you, hurt you, but they're not living saved. Mm-hmm. You understand that? And you shall be brought before governors and kings for my sake, for a testimony against them and the Gentiles. The government shall rise up, Jesus said, against the church. Laws shall be passed against the church. He said, but they will deliver you up, but take no thought on what you shall speak, for it shall be given to you in that hour what you shall say. He says, when these things happen, don't worry about it. He said, the Holy Ghost will help you defend yourself. For it is not you that speaketh, but the Spirit of your Father which speaketh in you. When people come against you because of your faith, God will help you defend. Amen. He's not leaving you by yourself. Now watch this. And the brother shall deliver the brother to death, and the father the child. And the children shall rise up against their parents and cause them to be put to death. You saw a lot of this during the Holocaust, during the time of Hitler's Germany, when he brainwashed many of the children and they began to turn their parents in and turn on each other and feel the virtue. But you see now, this is prophetic. This is prophetic. The devil comes to kill, steal, and destroy. And when you let the devil into your house, anybody hearing me? You're going to have a house divided. Understand what I'm saying? I'm talking to Christians now. You see, because the world don't stand a chance. Jesus said, think not that I come to send peace on earth. He said, but I come to send a sword. He said, I come to separate the righteous from the unrighteous. Amen. And he quoted the same thing as they were in Micah. You shall be hated of all men for my name's sake, but he that shall endure to the end, the same shall be saved. He said, now they will persecute you. If they persecute you, flee into one city, go into another. For brother, I say to you, you should not have gone over the cities of Israel till the Son of Man become. Verse 24 says, the disciple is not above his master, nor the servant above his Lord. It is not enough, he said, it is enough for the disciple that he be as his master and the servant as his Lord. If they have called the master of the house Beelzebub, how much more shall they call them of his household? In other words, they called Jesus the devil, Beelzebub, Lord of the flies. If they called him a devil, prince of the devils, what are they going to call us? Anybody hearing me? But he said, fear them not. Therefore, for there is nothing covered that should not be revealed, and hid that should not be known. What I tell you in darkness, that speak ye in the light. And what you hear in the ear, preach it up on the housetops. And fear not them which can kill the body, but are not able to kill the soul. But rather fear him which is able to destroy both body and soul. He talks about how the sparrows are sold for so much, and one of them shall not fall on the ground without God knowing. The very hairs of your head are numbered. God said, don't be afraid to stand up for what's right because the very hairs on your head are numbered. I got you. He says, whosoever shall confess me before men, him will I also confess before my Father which is in heaven. But whosoever shall deny me, I will deny you. Then he says, think not that I come to send peace on earth. Here we go again. I came not to send peace, but a sword. Quoting from Micah, for I come to set a man at variance against his father, a daughter against her mother, a daughter-in-law against his mother-in-law, and a man's foe, which means enemy, shall be they of his own household. He that loveth father and mother more than me is not worthy of me. He that loveth son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And he that taketh not his cross and followeth after me is not worthy of me. He that findeth his life shall lose it, and he that loseth his life for my sake shall find it. Church, say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
You cannot put people before God.
Amen.
You cannot do it.
Amen.
These are the last and evil days.
Amen.
You have to put Christ first. And there are plenty of examples that explain that this is not a hate message toward the family. It's a message of security.
Amen.
God said this. He was going to destroy Sodom and Gomorrah, but there was Lot, his daughters, and his wife. He told them to leave because fire was coming that night, and he sent angels to get them out. And he said, don't look back, but Mrs. Lot looked back and was turned into a pillar of salt.
Man.
Now, if her daughters had followed her, they too would have turned.
Man.
You have, I feel a virtue, to put God first.
Man.
David made a mistake, and he was a man after God's own heart, but he made a mistake. But he had to send his army out to fight because he had a son that actually wanted to kill him. As a matter of fact, he killed one of his brothers who raped one of the sisters.
Man.
You got to put God first, people.
Man.
Because your blood don't mean you're going to do the right thing. But when you're led by the Spirit of God, you will do the right thing.
Amen.
And if you err, you will correct it. You have to put Christ first because in putting Jesus first, he helps you to treat everybody the way they should be treated.
Amen.
Is anybody hearing me?
Right.
You see, listen, whatever you put your hands on, whoever you lay your hands upon, whoever you decide to walk with, if they are against God, you are against God.
Amen.
I feel the virtue. Now, to some of you, this may be boring, but I don't care how bored you are. But I got news for you. Ain't a boring moment in hell.
Amen.
You understand what I'm saying? Think not that I come to send peace.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody's word should override the word of the Lord.
Amen.
And you have to face the fact. Could he really be this way? Do they really feel this way? No. Sometimes, yeah. And they're your own family members because they're not being guided by the Holy Ghost. And a man's enemy shall be there of his own household. But when you have Jesus in the midst, you can rebuke that spirit.
Amen.
Ha! If everybody's mind is staying on Christ, you can keep peace in the midst.
Amen.
But if the peace of God is not there, then even in your household, you're going to have to make a decision. If daddy's wrong, I can't follow him. If mama's wrong, I can't follow her. If brother's wrong, I can't follow him. If sister's wrong or granddaddy, grandmama, Lord help me, I can't do that. I have to do what's right.
Amen.
Yes, Lord.
Understand what I'm saying?
Thank you, Jesus.
And I keep feeling a virtue. Some of you don't understand that you're being tried by the simpleness of things.
Mm.
And one of your biggest trials is that internet.
Come on.
Don't you know that the things you put up there and the things you indulge in, you're going to get judged for? My God, if the government holds you accountable for it, what makes you think God's not?
Come on.
And some of you display things that are not right. Hello? And then some of you other backslidden minded people comment on it. Oh, that's all right. That's all right. That's all right because you're all going to hell. Straight up, straight down. You have to make a decision in your mind that for God you live and for God you die. God doesn't play. I know y'all like to play all the time. But playing is not an attribute of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
You cannot support anything. anybody that's walking ungodly, especially if they've been filled with the Holy Ghost,
man,
and have sided with the world. Are you serious?
Man.
Hey, and if you don't like it, then take your sinful behind and repent yourself on.
Amen.
If you don't like it, what? Trying to get into heaven. You see, we have compassion sometimes on the wrong thing.
Amen.
We get mad when somebody tries to straighten us out.
Come on.
But then we want to have compassion on those that are rebelling.
Preach.
I keep feeling the virtue.
Preach.
Listen, either you love God or you don't. And you say, that's a simple matter. When it was just a simple conversation that got us to the point where we're at now.
Amen.
Just say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And you young adults that are coming up. No, our parents ain't always been perfect and probably still ain't. But you don't want to get from under the hedge of protection.
Amen.
Because that world is not a joke.
Amen.
And it's not getting better. Amen. That devil will tear you every which way but loose.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. You don't want to be your own worst enemy. And many times we are because of the things that we allow. Now you just read it. This is not a Hitler message. This is not a cult message. You heard the Lord say that he must be first.
Amen.
He must be first. You cannot support even family members in doing that which is wrong.
Amen.
I keep feeling a virtue. Amen. Evidently, listen, I feel something. Let me humble myself. Lord, help me. I keep feeling a virtue. Sometimes I run across things. Sometimes I see things. And I use it very seldom, but I do. But I feel a virtue. There's something that I need to say. There has been a conversation. And some of you in here have been talking with people that ain't living right. And you think they're making sense. But the Holy Ghost says they are not.
Come on.
You are being tried by God.
Amen.
The Bible, I hear a conversation. Watch, you see? I told you. Now watch this and watch that. Don't even buy it. Don't even buy it. I keep feeling the virtue. Don't allow the spirit of backsliders and the spirit of those who have a wrong spirit to pull you. Because once you get outside of the hedge of protection and your eyes are open, oh, woe is you.
Amen.
As a matter of fact, somebody say, give me a Bible.
Amen.
Let me give you a Bible for it. Joab was a strong man. He was a mighty man. He was a captain of the army of David, but he was a wicked man. He killed innocent people. He did what he wanted to do. He was rebellious, and he was powerful too. A good warrior, but he was rebellious. But when his sins caught up with him, and it was time for him to pay the price for his sins, he thought he was getting away with it. But before David died, he told his son Solomon, don't you let Joab go to his grave in peace because he has hurt innocent people. Be sure you get him. Now here's a man that broke all the rules, killed his cousin, David's favorite son, killed another man more righteous than him, killed Abner, lied to him and tricked him more righteous than him, rebuked David. He was almighty. But when it came time for him to get judgment, he gonna run to the horns of the altar and ask for mercy. He's gonna go and start trying to pray. Anybody hearing me? Jezebel was a wicked woman married to the king Ahab. And there was a man named Naboth who had good land, but it was next to the king's land. And Ahab wanted the land. He was a wicked man too. He served the god Baal along with his wicked wife, and he was Hebrew. He should have never done that. But he couldn't get the land according to the law. She came to him one day and said, what's wrong with you? I need that land. Why don't you take it? I can't because the law says I can't. She says, I'll fix it. She goes and have two evil men lie on Naboth, take him to court, lie on him, and they stoned him to death. Then she came back and said, the land is yours. He took it and was all happy, and God sent the prophet. Oh, he was all happy until God sent the prophet and said, man, get your house in order because you're about to die. And what did he do? He cries out. Oh, my God. Even when David had a righteous man killed to take his wife, he was blinded. When he caught up with him and the prophet said, David, you are guilty of this sin, David fell down to his knees and said, woe is me. Judas, got mad at Jesus because he got rebuked. Like some of y'all getting mad with a Judas spirit because I'm rebuking you. Because that's just what I'm doing. But when he realized his eyes were open, he was wrong, he goes back and throws the money back. Take the money back. I don't want it. But before he betrayed the Lord, the Bible said the devil entered into him. And when he realized he was wrong, he comes back. I don't want the money. Crying. They said, we don't care. Then he hangs himself. So what am I trying to tell you? You get mad. You get angry. You side with backsliders and blasphemers and give your ear to the ungodly. Once you come to your senses and the judgment falls, it's going to be a different story.
Amen. Preach.
Think not that I come to send peace. The Holy Ghost said you better. You young folks better straighten up. You old folks better straighten up. You think it's nothing, but God looks at everything. Revelation says in the books will open, and every man shall be judged according to every deed done in the body. Now, if you're in that judgment, you're lost anyway. But you're being judged now. Judgment begins where, church? In the house of God. In the house of God. You don't need to walk around being judgmental and being mad and unforgiving. You might not be able to walk with somebody, but you definitely got to forgive them. Why? Because you're going to need it tomorrow.
That's right. Amen.
You're going to need it. Who are you? You're going to need it. Church, say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And then you all get together and deny the Lord Jesus Christ, presenting yourselves in ungodly mannerism. I feel a virtue.
Come on.
And then others join hand in hand. You hypocrites.
Mercy.
Give me a friend that's going to help me stay safe.
Yes, Lord.
Because that's what it, listen, I've been to the pathway of hell. That's why I preach it with such passion. I felt the flame. It does exist. I've seen holy angels with my own two eyes. This is not a joke. And so, what are you angry about? The Holy Ghost is upon me. You better stop fooling with these backsliders who ain't trying to repent. Because let me tell everybody something. If you have received, Hebrews says, the Holy Ghost, and you have tasted of the powers of what? The world to come. Anybody hear what I said?
Amen.
The Holy Ghost is a taste of the powers of what? The world to come. You got the Holy Ghost, then there's a world coming. You have the Holy Ghost, then there's a real kingdom of God.
Amen.
And the Bible says if you willfully, purposely continue to do wrong with the Holy Ghost in you, that there will be no more for the virtue, no more forgiveness of sin. You become a reprobate. A reprobate is someone whose mind has been turned. Now, Holy Ghost is upon me. Now, you sit there. Y'all hear me? Play around with your minds. I don't know if I want to be saved. I don't know if I want the Lord. I don't know if it, you keep on playing with that mind. One day, you're going to wake up, and that's what it's going to be. And you're not going to be able to get saved if you try. Because God will give you over to that foolishness.
My Lord.
And that's it.
Have mercy, Jesus.
That's it. I've seen reprobates. I've seen their torment when they realize that they have been turned aside because of their own. Anybody hearing me?
Amen.
And so understand, and suicide is not an answer. It don't solve nothing. You're still here in hell. Mm-hmm. But God is able to keep us. He's letting us know that the enemy could be next door. And he's not teaching hate, but he's teaching priority. Put me first. I'll protect you. I can help you. I can keep you because he's the only one that's going to take us out of here. Meaning catch us up to meet him in the air. This is why Jesus said he was preaching. And he said, they said, Jesus, here comes your mother, your brothers, and your sisters. They thought he was going to stop the program. And Jesus turned around, looked at all the disciples, and he said, who is my mother, my brother, and my sister? But them that do the will of my Father.
Amen.
Those that do the will of God, regardless of their color, creed, nationality. They that do the will of God and walk according to Scripture, that's your family in the eyes of God.
Amen.
Blood is blood, true enough, but spirit is thicker than blood. I keep feeling something here. Lord, word my mouth, let me be so exact. I keep hearing a conversation. My God. Somebody, you are tapping into the wrong spirit. And you're going to know not many days hence that it's the wrong spirit. Because it's going to backfire on you, and you're going to see the people you're connecting to, you're going to see them for what they really are. Anybody hearing me?
Amen.
I will not take it back. I keep feeling a spirit of communication, of connection that is not right. This is what church is all about. You're going to find yourself outside of the grace of God, and don't even buy that picture, that story, once saved, always. That's not written. It is not written. He that endureth till the end shall be saved. If you truly saved, you can make it. But there have been people, amen, that the scriptures declare was brought out, but they didn't make it. Let us take heed to ourselves. We don't want to lose this great salvation. But if you practice a little rebellion, it levels the whole lump. A little leaven levels the whole lump. And we're looking for you young adults coming up. The Holy Ghost is trying to find some of y'all that really believe in holy living.
Amen.
So that we know that the chest is going to be all right.
Come on now. Man.
Understand, you're very important. Because one day, you young brothers and sisters are going to be up here instructing others. And if you got a compromising spirit, Lord have mercy. And you can't always look at what others do, but you got to keep your eyes on the Lord.
Amen.
And he already said you're going to be offended. Brother against brother, father against daughter, daughter against mother. Yeah. There might be some folks in your own household that you wonder, God, are you with them? They may say, God, are you with them? And everything they do may not be holy. You know the enemy is there. But you got to put God first. He'll fix it. He'll keep you. Put your trust in him. And those that love God will do what? Walk as one. Those that love God will walk as one. But I keep feeling that virtue. Let me tell you something. You people compromise all you want to with that world. It's going to get you. Hell has no respect to person. It's an equal opportunity. You got one life. Live it right. Stop. My God, are you serious? It's like this. There is someone, ladies, you know how ladies get to gabbing today, men to get gabbing because you got very few men today. But nevertheless, say, ladies, there is a lady that man you can't stand, and maybe rightfully so. Maybe she ain't got nothing good to say about you. She's always putting you down, always talking about you. You're trying your best to get along with her. But she's just wicked, bottom line, when it comes to you. And then you see someone that you love. As a matter of fact, supposed to be your closest friend. You understand me?
Mm-hmm.
Walking with that lady, laughing with her, talking with her, and even they're dressing alike today. And your friend knows how this lady despises you. It's no secret. Now, if anybody in here in their right mind got a good, if you really be honest, you're going to have to think twice about your friend. How in the world you going to dress like her? You didn't call me this morning and tell me what you're putting on. And we do everything together. And you know that this woman hates my guts. And you laughing and walking with her and calling her your friend. And so God says, how is it that you're going to dress like the devil? Act like the devil? Walk like the devil? Walk with them that's walking with the devil? And you know how he feels about me.
Man.
How is after that, you're going to side with a backslider, laugh with a backslider, hug and do everything for a backslider who has turned their back on the living God to serve the devil and say you love God.
Come on.
I keep feeling the virtue. I don't know why I'm saying this. If you have made an appointment to go fellowship with a backslider, break it. Because if you don't, you're going to wish you had it. I keep feeling something. I keep feeling the virtue. If you have connected your spirit with one, with someone that has walked out on God. Somebody say, well, they got their reasons because look. We can all find reasons to say and do whatever. But as the song said, they may try to blame the remaining few, but they're without excuse, Lord, because they can find no fault in you. Ain't no fault in him. The bottom line is, we didn't shed our blood. Your brothers and sisters didn't shed their blood. He shedded the blood. Now find fault in him. And you can't do that. So then why get mad at others and take it out on him? And then the minute something goes wrong, you want him to help you. Now you got some folk that say they don't need God's help. They're just that big and bad. But when they get to hell, it's going to be a different story.
Amen.
Somebody say, how you know? I'm glad to ask, because it said every knee shall bow.
Amen.
To how big and bad you were, your knee bowing and your tongue will confess.
Amen.
He's going to win. He's already won. So what the Holy Ghost is trying to say is there's a sword. I've preached this before, but it came back again. There's a sword. There's a sword. Now, don't get me wrong. I've learned, like Moses chose to take the suffering with the people of God and to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a moment. And I chose that. I chose the church good with the bad.
Man.
And believe me, when I came into the church world, I didn't come into good people.
Mm-hmm.
I came into all kind of stuff as a young convert. But I said, I'm going to stand with the church. I'm going to stand with Christ.
Amen.
No matter what. Then to give up and get into that world. I'm going to stand with Christ and he will lead and guide me. Yeah, but see, some of y'all ain't like that. Y'all sit there and give your ear to garbage. You sit there and watch folk criticize. And they telling you they with the devil and you still giving them high five. But let me tell you something. There have been situations here when backsliders and stuff have risen up against some of you all and they got to my ear. And my reply was, you tell them, don't come here with that.
Amen.
Don't come here with that. They would like to know, no, they can't come over here. No, they can't. Why? They speaking against a saint like that, and I'm going to walk with them? I don't think so.
Mm-hmm.
And the saint might not have been quite right, but they still holding on. I'll deal with the saint that needs help before I side with a backslider putting down the church.
Amen.
And that goes for backsliders in the house and outside the house.
Amen.
It comes down to this. Do you love the Lord?
Amen.
Do you love the Lord?
Amen.
Your bodies are the temple of the Holy Ghost.
Mm-hmm.
You belong to Christ. Church, say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
That's why, like y'all folks, y'all ain't ready yet. Y'all playing around with sin and amening each other. Don't realize you're being partakers of another person's sin. And you get together and you do things you know you got no business doing. And my God, Lord, don't even let me say it. I'm not going to say that. Being prophetic, I'm not going to say it. Just don't be caught doing the wrong thing at the wrong time. I'm not going to say it. Just don't be caught doing the wrong thing at the wrong time. And then all of a sudden you want to pray. Anybody hear me?
Amen.
You play with fire, you get burnt. You cannot support. And let me say this again. Maybe somebody's not hearing me. Let me see if I can say this. And this is something everybody needs to see. And I have little ones that I love, you hear me? But with certain lifestyles and certain connections, I tell them don't bring it around my house.
Amen.
I will not support it. And don't bring it. Amen. If you bold enough, if they bold enough to exalt the devil, should you not be bold enough to lift up the Lord?
Amen.
It says, you all know the scripture. Be ye not equally yoked together, is that right? With unbelievers. It's in 2 Corinthians 6, it says, be ye not unequally yoked together with unbelievers. For what fellowship have righteousness with unrighteousness? This is all Jesus said. I come to bring a sword. What communion has light with darkness? Isn't this what the word said?
Amen.
What agreement conquer has Christ with the devil? And what does he that believe have in common with an infidel, an unbeliever? Mm-hmm. Now if I say, what agreement does Christ have with the devil? Now y'all gonna raise your hands, Lord, trying to make an agreement. Because you've been deceived. He doesn't agree. What agreement has the temple of God with idols? For you are the temple of the living God. As God said, I will dwell in them, walk in them, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. Where are you taking God tonight? Where did you take him last night, last week?
Mom.
Where are you taking him? Oh, you're going to pay for it. I said you're going to pay for it, people. You're going to pay for it. Wherefore, come out from among them and be ye what?
Separate,
said the Lord, and touch not what? That's what it said. You cannot be unequally yoked together in any form or fashion with those who deny the Lord, those who walk away from the living God. You cannot do it. Church, say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
This is what he said. That's New Testament. But it's an old message. Amen? And let me close with this and see if I can find something real quick here. You know, Deuteronomy 13 tells you that if anybody come to you and try to tell you to turn away from God, you got to tell on them. In other words, stand up against them. It doesn't make a difference who it is. You stand up against them because they're trying to cause you to lose your very soul. In Deuteronomy, it talks about that do not give your children to the world, meaning don't let them join hand in hand and marry children that are not of God. It said because what's going to happen? Most of the time your child is not going to win them to Christ. They're going to lead them further away from God. Think about it. Think about all the so-called Holy Ghost-filled saints that call themselves connected to folk that ain't saved yet. They're not living saved as a couple. That saint, supposedly, is doing what they do. God said he hates that. He said that he's angry with that. Does anybody hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
He said he disapproves of that. And I agree with him. He said because they would turn your sons and your daughters away from me. And he said, this will make them angry. Church, say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I keep feeling a virtue. Now, anybody want to get mad, listen. This is my last run. I'm going to make it in. I'm running. You can't stop me. I'm going to keep running.
Amen.
And I learned not to be afraid of your faces, young and old. The devil can use anybody.
Amen.
But your enemy is closer than you think. You don't want to be the enemy of God.
Amen.
You don't want to be the enemy of God.
Amen.
You don't want to be the enemy of God.
Amen.
Church, say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
These are the last and evil days. You don't want to fulfill the scriptures of rebellion.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. And those that you know, as I said before, any so-called person who had the Holy Ghost comes around and they are connected to an ungodly individual, you should have no fellowship with them. If you do, you're blaspheming, just like they are. The scripture says that is an automatic blasphemy. Be ye not unequally yoked together. God is not in that. Period. Doesn't need an interpreter. It's wrong. Have nothing to do with it. Hate, no, but have nothing to do with it. Don't put your hand in that. Unless you, amen, if you die tomorrow, you're going to hell, and everything in you could have been straight, but that sin becomes your sin.
Amen.
Anybody hearing me?
Amen.
You can't help a brother or sister out by patting them on the back when they do wrong. Mm-hmm. You have to make it plain that this is wrong. Mm-hmm. This is wrong. Now, I know some of y'all folks doing this, but what I tell you, don't bring it around me. Don't bring it to my house. I still love you, but I got nothing to do with it. Mm-hmm. Nothing at all, and I'm telling you, I got nothing to do with it. Don't bring that blasphemy around me. And don't take it to none of the saints' houses that's trying to live all right. Keep your sin to yourself. If you bold enough to sin, knowing that it's against God, I'm bold enough to tell you to get behind me, Satan.
Amen.
Somebody got to speak up. Church, say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Anybody mad yet? You might be. But it's all right, because there's nothing you can do against the power of the Holy Ghost. Nothing you can do against the power of the Holy Ghost. Church, say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And you have to put God first. The enemy is closer than you think. And if you are set on going against God, you're my enemy. I love you, but you're my enemy. Because I'm not finna turn on him. I'm not finna turn on him. So I'm not talking about you going through trials and tribulations. Don't let your mind play with you. Because whoever wants of a man thinking in his heart, what? You keep them up, this and this and that, God will say, okay, well, there it is. Why didn't you do something about it? We all have things we go through. That's not what I'm talking about, people. I'm talking about those of you who are deliberately playing around with rebellion. You get mad at the way other people act, and then you turn around and get an attitude just as bad as theirs. Repent. Repent. Young folk, I know your friends. Y'all hear me? Young people, I know your friends. You love each other, but don't go to hell, because somebody want to walk with the devil. What kind of friendship is that?
To side,
brothers and sisters, with the very enemy of God Almighty. Are you serious? Put God first. Father, mother, bishop, deacons, prophetess, if they don't serve God, you serve God. You serve God. Apostle Paul said, if an angel from heaven, or if even he himself turns around and tells you that Christ is not real, he said, let him be accursed. If I come around and tell you the apostle doctrine is not real, don't believe me. If I turn around and say you don't have to be holy, don't believe me. Pray for me. Oh my God, Bishop has been deceived. Because the truth is the truth. The truth belongs to God. And we receive it, but it's his. Anybody hear me? The truth is the truth. It doesn't change. The scriptures cannot be broken. Church, say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
It doesn't make it. If anybody talking to you that which is against the teaching, Paul said this, you got 10,000 instructors, but you only got one father, he said. He said, I begot you in the gospel. You got 10,000 people that can tell y'all something, but you got one father, meaning spiritually, I begot you in the gospel. I birthed you through Christ Jesus. You listen to the words of the elders that are doing right. I feel a virtue. Precious God, show forth your power that can break every yoke. Let the Spirit of God go forth with conviction. And let the Holy Ghost battle with the Prince of Atlanta. Let him battle with the demonic oppressions of this city. Let him battle with the oppression demons that try to oppress the saints. Hasatokar Maria Kosita now. I bind every rebel Holy Spirit, strengthen the heart that will repent. Help them to swallow their pride and let God be true and every man alive. Open our eyes to see reality of the spirit realm. That those who play in sin come to destroy us. Bringing in the devil, my God, after you paid the price. I keep feeling a virtue. Lord, give strength to the weak. To those that want to say something but they don't know how, give them the strength to say it. Give us strength to say to one another, you need to stop that. Be not partakers of another man's sin. Young and old, only few shall be saved. Elijah was talking to the servant of Ben-Hadad of Syria. Ben-Hadad had fallen sick, and he said, go and ask the prophet of Israel, am I going to live? And when he went to the prophet looked at the servant and started crying. And the servant said, my father, why are you crying? He said, because I can see what your sword is going to do to my people. In other words, I can see you're going to become the next ruler. And he cried. And when the man went back to Ben-Hadad, his master, I believe it was, Ben-Hadad was asleep, and he took a wet towel and he smothered him, that he would die, because he knew that he would become ruler. You know, you never want to jump ahead of God. If it's for you, it's for you, right? But he knew, evidently God knew he would do that. But however, my point is this. When the prophet saw the man, he cried because he saw what he was going to do. And sometimes in the spirit, when I look at some of you, I cry because I can see the damage you're doing to yourself and the damage that you don't realize that you're going to do to the rest of the saints that walk around you. Now, don't talk foolish. Don't talk foolish like the man whom God gave one talent, and God said, where's the talent? Where's the money? He said, because I knew you were a austere man. You were hard to get along with. I hid it. God said, I'm going to judge you by your words. Let me remind you. Don't talk foolish. Well, I don't want to bother nobody. I don't want to contaminate nobody. I ain't no good. All right, he's going to say, if you knew you were contaminating, if you knew you weren't no good, you should have done something about it. Don't talk foolish. Let God be God with all of his mercy and all of his grace. Just humble yourself. And don't get an attitude. When I just leave, oh my God, you better be careful before he removes you. So while you're still here, take advantage of it. There's still hope. Just let him work on you. We've all been there. We've all been there. We all need a spanking every once in a while. Because he loves us, he chastises. But make no mistake. Y'all play with each other, but know from the bishop's mouth, this ministry, there's none to play with. And it's not a joke. The laugh is on you. Because the Holy Ghost is real. And there is no other way to serve God except to be born again of water and of the Spirit. And to be filled with the power of God's Spirit. The Apostles' Doctrine is the only teaching that brings true salvation. The only teaching in the scriptures. There is no other plan of salvation, neither is there any other name given among men under the heavens whereby we must be saved. So if you think you're going to stand to meet Jesus, you want to live right now. Amen. Precious God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you. I feel a virtue. Give the Lord a hand clap offering. Appreciate you, Lord. Ah! Hallelujah! Ah, hallelujah! Lord, give us fear that will cause us to depart from iniquity. Help promise to stand throughout eternity. Why won't you come, church, come to Jesus right now. God bless you. May the virtue go forth and strengthen you. May the virtue heal you. The anointing that is of many, may it heal you. And may it keep you. Open your eyes, young and old. Practice makes perfect, they say. Start living saved now so that it becomes a part of your life. Because trust me, even when I was a young thug on the streets of St. Louis, we were big and bad, this and that. But sooner we got busted, we cried for mama. Because we weren't old enough to get ourselves out. We praying to God, not that an angel will come, but Lord, please let mama come and get me out just one more time. Got busted one day with some partners and cutthroat partners. And I didn't really care what happened to me at the time because a lot of divorces was going on in my home and I thought my mother didn't love me, so I figured she didn't care. Why should I? I was wrong, but I was young and foolish. And the policeman came and he almost shot me. And all of my friends dropped their heads and they said LB because I didn't see the gun as I was about to make a way for us to escape. Paraphrasing. As a matter of fact, I don't know how he didn't pull the trigger. I don't know how I froze from a full swing. But 6 months later, I saw the man driving on the motorcycle and I said, how are you, officer? He said, I quit the force. I said, oh, why'd you quit the force? He said, 6 months ago, I almost killed him, boy. He said, I almost blew his chest off. I said, that was me, sir. He looked at me with fear in his face. He said, you were a dead man. And he drove off. Then I knew God kept me.
Man.
But my point is this. Some of my buddies had had several convictions. And I saw strong guys bowing their heads crying. Oh, man, I can't go back. Oh, man. Oh, man. Then I realized that sometimes the strong ain't strong as they appear to be.
Man.
Or you may be. Or we were strong and cocky kicking that door. We were big and bad. But when it came time to get busted, even the mob gets some of the protection.
Amen.
So don't be big and bad if you ain't gonna stay that way. You're gonna go to hell big and bad. When you get there, you won't be. But I'm just saying, don't be afraid to humble yourself. It's all right. It's all right. It's all right to humble yourself and let God be true. Because you have to enter in. I keep feeling the virtue. You see, you can get mad at me or anybody all you want to rise up, but you have to pay for what you do.
Amen.
You can't say, well, God, he made me. God said, I understand what happened, but you had an obligation to serve me. You have to put God first. I rebuke the contaminated spirit. I send it back where it comes from. I place a hedge, Lord, upon the innocent. And I command that contaminating spirit to be removed by the power of the Holy Ghost. Let it be revealed, the selfishness of a contaminating, deceiving, and backslidden spirit. Let the selfishness be manifested. The rebellion. How dare anybody sin against my God, talk against his body, and he is the same one keeping them alive. Make a stand, people. Make a stand. Church, say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Make a stand. Make a stand. Children, family members, make a stand. And stop letting sinners boast with their God and you sit there and do nothing. I'm speaking to backsliders. Let them know their error in love that they may repent. Make a stand. I don't want to lose them. You already lost them.
Amen.
Try to win them back. How? Make a stand. Make a stand. Nowhere in the world you're going to curse my God and walk with me.
Amen.
That's not finna happen. Son, that's not finna happen. He's too good. The enemy is closer than you think. I keep feeling the virtue. We thank you, Lord. We appreciate you. In Jesus' name, let's pray, amen.
Amen.
Give the Lord a hand clap, offering.